anybody? I don't know what else to talk about. That's our video for Some Days Gone. I wanted to show it to you and tell you a couple little secrets. My favorite
one. What do you think?
Whoa, whoa. What? Huh? What now?
What do you back, bro? What's your drink from Starbucks?
Oh, what do I? Oh, I'm the green tea latte guy. I'm that guy.
Well,
yeah, I can't handle caffeine. I went on a date the other night and a girl gave me tea and I was like, oh, ooh, herbal tea, beautiful. And I drank a cup of it and I'm like, was this black tea? Is there caffeine in this tea? She's like, oh yeah, I forgot to tell you that. And I started like acting like a complete moron because it made me so jittery and wild. Is there a dude in his bed? What's this dude?
I'm seeing it now.
I'm not in bed.
Oh,
I'm in bed.
I'm in bed. It's late. Whoa, what did I just do? Whoa.
Comfortable place to work.
What else can
I love
we
all
do?
The confetti.
I like confetti too. Jay Zalowitz.
He's a good guy, I think.
Where are you at, Jay?
Jay, are you at the
office right now? He's taking off his headset. He's like, fuck this. I can't handle this.
He's like,
Jay Zalowitz.
I think he just took it off and I'm not hearing you.
We're all curious.
Oh, he can hear us.
Who is Jay Zalowitz? What is his alter? Is he like? Where do you think he works? This Jay Zalowitz guy.
He's a journalist.
He's looking up.
He says he can't hear. Check it out.
Ah. Unfortunate. Mitchell Brown. What's up, man? I see you have your stocking hung with care by the mantle.
I got something better.
The stockings are hung by the chimney with care. Right.
There you go.
So you still believe in Santa Claus? Which is cool, because it's important. I am a Festivus believer myself. We have a hole in my house.
Ooh, pizza strain! Pizza strain!
Festivus for the rest of us.
Rebecca! Festivus!
I want to know what you do for your feats of strength. If you've got the pole, you got to have feats of strength.
That's right.
And Mr. Grievance.
That's right.
And maybe if you're good, you'll get a man's ear.
Yes.
It's the bro.
It's the bro. We're quoting Seinfeld for all you people who are too young.
Hello.
Hey, Mitchell, I'm talking to you.
Daughter's headset.
Oh, gotcha.
The mic wasn't working.
All right. Jacob, you are Satan, aren't you? But you still have your Christmas lights up. It's like you're the darkest man in the room, but you still have like this jolly air behind you. So you're not that evil.
Actually, that was Dr. Claw.
Oh, that was Dr. Claw. And every time Mike, our guitarist, every accent he has is the same, so we'll be like, do an Australian accent, Mike. He's like, that's not a knife. You know, and then we'll be like, do a Scottish accent, and he'll be like, that's not a knife. Pretty good. All right, well, for those of you who have hung out, my mom is actually getting ready to completely destroy. I wonder what her voicemail is. Let's hear how angry she is with me.
How angry is she that you let your little sister get a tattoo?
All right, you want to hear the wrath of my mother real quick?
Totally, put it on.
This shit's getting ready to get real in my world.
This is your mom, and you better call me really quick.
That's it, dude. Shit has officially hit the fan.
No kidding.
All right, so does this mustache program work?
Whoa, you used to have the stash. Very nice.
Oh, I see. Yeah, if you hit it again, it'll change it.
If you click it again, it'll change. You can get all sorts of different ones.
No way.
Way? Why would I lie to you?
That's a
That's
a good French one right there.
I would like to back it.
Whack our theme, this mustache.
They need, hey, they need
there,
to have
little
a
girl. Is your mother home?
They need to have a Charlie Chaplin one in here.
I don't think they have the Charlie Chaplin because it's kind of
like, that Hitler guy.
It's a little. It's been sort of burnt out.
Mamma mia.
Hey, are you liking a pizza? I make one a special for you. All
right. I have the mustache, and now I don't have the mustache. That pisses me off so much.
I can't believe it can track your face so well. It's like, I wonder, does it go, does it turn to the side? No, the floating stash.
Actually,
there it is. It's back on you.
I found out that you can do a, mustache transfer.
Yeah. If you have
Somebody has.
Yeah, if you have another person in the room with you, you cover your face, and you need this, and then it goes back to them.
Okay. Okay, I'll be right back.
All right. Well, you guys, I'm gonna go get my ass chewed by my mother, and please spread the love about our new video and song, "Someday's Gone," because I don't know. We're really excited about putting out a new record next year, and it's not our first single, but it's just sort of like the first taste of sort of where this new record's going. And the song itself is about. I'd like to share what it's about. It's about this horrible person I met. It's a beautiful sociopath. For those people who have met those kind of people, so. It's one of my favorite songs because it came towards the end of the record when we were writing, and I had been looking for like a middle finger to this person the whole time I had been writing, and every time I'd sit down and try to write about it, it'd just feel forced. So then I was just sitting in my house one day, and when I write songs, I usually write to synths or piano or, you know, anything that's key based, like even like a banjo on keys, because I really, when I play on the piano, I sort of lose myself and I sort of hear my head instead of like when I'm on a guitar, there's so many strings and it's not as linear as a piano. Piano is all laid out in one big line, and the guitar is like six different lines that you have to sort of orchestrate to voice chords. Which isn't difficult, it's just distracting to sort of when I'm thinking of a melody. So, this was actually the first time I just grabbed my bass and I just started playing like root notes. And I wrote this verse, and I was like, in my Florida house, I was like, and I was like, it was like a cool moment because I was like, this song, this is my fuck you song. Finally, and you know, I've always been sort of weary about swearing because I feel like when it's used, I mean, when I talk, I curse like a sailor, but when it's used in songs that I listen to, I'll be like, man, when that dude said fuck, it sounded so contrived. But this is a moment in the song where it's my first F-bomb on a record, and I guess I'm proud of it because it's befitting. It befits the song because it's the truest moment of the song where, you know, I always talk about myself in third person when I'm talking about the narrator of the song. So I'm like, this is where the guy loses his mind, and the song that starts out really chaotic, like, na 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 na. When we were recording with Greg Wells, like the song, the demo of the song sounded totally different. The demo of the song was like, it's like, put me in dinner. It was very like kind of Cars, like a little poppier. And like we got in the studio and we all set up to play live, and I was like, let's just this song is not gross enough yet. Like this song needs to be like a car wreck. And so that beginning, the da na na na, that part wasn't written yet, and so I was just like sort of messing around. I was like, you know, when you get in the moment of a song and you're like living in it, it's like you're putting on a you're put on an outfit and you're like, it's, or you're like put on a costume and you're like, I'm a fucking bear, so I'm gonna act like a bear. And I was just sort of like, and everybody's like, cool, let's do this, let's do this. And then we all sort of started like with this energy, and Chris just started hitting the cans, and it was like, da 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 da. And then we went right into the verse, and I was like, let's just drop it to the bass and hit it from there. And Nick just was like, it came in just like halfway through the verse, and it just felt raw, and we just picked it up from there, and the song sort of developed back into that. And it was a really special, like, little magical moment when we were making with our new record. And
yeah, it does kind of have an 80s vibe to it.
Yes, yes. Thank you for chiming in with that, sweetheart. I appreciate that.
I love how Jay has walked away from his seat and now the mustache is just floating there.
I love how my mustache just jiggles. I also want to tell you guys that tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Pacific time, we're going to be live on air with my buddy Matt, who is DJ Roststar. And his website is www.stickam.com/DJRossStar, and he'll be we're gonna play another new song off the record tomorrow at that. So it'll just be me and Nick interviewing, talking about the new record, talking about where it's going, and talking about how excited we are for it. So you know.
Do you know when it's released? When is the new record coming out?
The new record is coming out. I don't know. You should probably watch that Sunday's Gone video again.
Oh, that date that was circled on the calendar. It was in March.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't remember. You should tell me.
I'm 40 years old, so my memory is not what it used to be.
Well, I'm 27 years old, and my memory. What were we talking about?
I'm 23. I can't remember last night.
Well done, sir.
I finally get my mic working, and everyone leaves. That's
good. Wait. Are we talking? Jay, is that Jay?
Yeah.
Jay, we have been waiting for your voice to join the crowd. I was wondering where are you working at?
The FT, if you've ever heard of us, Financial Times.
Whoa, so you're a finance guy.
No, I'm more media.
The finance journalist.
I'm not even a journalist. I'm a product manager, so I just do that nerdy stuff.
So basically you're in the clear unless somebody looks over your cubicle right now.
Actually the guy who was sitting behind me was my boss.
His job to be here.
Nice.
It's my job to know about social media, so I'm just...
Oh, well, you're doing research right now. Market research.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
I envy the people who work at Jack Daniels who have to do, like, research
for
on...
For research, yeah.
I envy the people at Jack Daniels as well.
Put on a mustache, Jay. Grab a mustache. Oh. Last thing on the...
All right, you guys. Well, hey. It's been a pleasure.
And the pleasure is ours.
It is a leisure to have your pleasure. You guys have a great day, and check us out tomorrow night around 7 Pacific time if you want to hear a new song off the record and hear about sort of how we came to create what will be coming out this spring. And if you watch the Some Days Gone video, you might know exactly when it's coming out.
Hey, is that when you said it was DJ Roststar, could you spell that?
Roststar.
Perfect.
Wait, I think...
I can pick an actual, like, British awesome person to do your cube talk.
Yeah, sure. Roststar.
Three S's. Okay, lovely.
Like the www.izzard.
Yes.
Thanks, Bobby Joe.
I just put it in the chat. That's the correct thing. All
right, people. Until next time.
Impromptu hangout. Lovely to hang.
Mm. Yes.
May your mustache jiggle forever.
Hey Tyson, my friend.
Long may it jiggle.
My friend Leani in Brazil says hi, and she wishes she could be in here, but she wanted to let you know they're already playing that song on the radio.
What the hell
there.
Are they
She's
doing with that?
Day.
Why are they doing that? I don't care. That's amazing. Tell her thank you. Tell her I give her credit for making that happen.
Here's my garden.
All right, people.
I'm gonna go play in the garden.
Here's my garden. It's so fun. I'm gonna go play in the garden. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, everybody. I'm shamelessly checking because I should be working.